when I first started, I had studied women's studies here, and I, you know, read very deep into third wave feminism and intersectional feminism and all of that and how I just was very like in tune with that world. So I didn't want to publish a song like just assuming that I was going to be a part of that movement and that I could say all these things and it's okay because I'm under the third wave umbrella. I didn't want to assume that kind of privilege. And I also didn't want to be put under a microscope with that crowd also that's saying, well, My Vag isn't a feminist song because it's girl on girl hate and you're talking about this and it's ableist and it's doing these, and, you know, I didn't want to get put in that. And so when I first came out, I was very scared of talking about it in a way that would pigeonhole me into being kind of like a militant feminist, which I didn't want to come across. And I also didn't think was necessarily fair because I literally have a vagina. So that's why I wrote the song. But it wasn't until a little bit later that I realized that it was impactful and that I think it did appear radical to a lot of women. And I think it was like a little bit later when I finally realized like you have to own up to the reaction that this is causing, you know? Like you may not want this to think that it's impactful or whatever, but other people do and other people are moved by it. So you have to kind of accept that. And I think as I did, it became less about like skirting around feminisms than just kind of embracing that like you are one and that, you know, whatever you can do to feed a movement is very important, you know? So yeah, now I'm okay with it. I also performed in front of Gloria Steinem. I performed Queef in front of Gloria Steinem and she told me that I was brave. So that was super cool and kind of not a compliment.